Honey, I love it. It's me. Oh, let's stop talking about dead and old marriages, okay? I'm so excited about your engagement to Alex. Have you set a date yet?
We're going to be married as soon as we can. After I talk to Dennis, there's one last thing I have to get straight.
Iris, you have been talking like that ever since Alex popped back in your life. Now, are you going to tell me what makes your voice go so funny?
Well, Dennis doesn't like Alex.
Honey, Dennis is a grown man. What difference does it make what he thinks of Alex? I mean, surely it's not going to make any difference as to whether you marry him or not.
No. Except...
Except what? Honey, Dennis may not be willing to visit you two, but so what? You can see each other on your own time.
Yes, but it's more than that.
Honey, you've been going around this bush for so long that all that's left is a fig leaf. Now, will you please tell me what the big secret is?
Well, since I have to find a way to tell Alex and Dennis, maybe I should practice by saying it to you. When I married Eliot Carrington, I was already pregnant. I never told him. He thought Dennis was his son, but Dennis's real father...
Alex. I should have known that the age, the look. Oh. Honey, I don't blame you for keeping this under wraps. I don't envy you to have to tell Dennis that Alex is his real father.
You never know how good it is.
I didn't recognize you. You've lost so much weight. What'd they do, starve you?
Oh, no, that was the easiest part, doing without food. It was being cut off from the outside world, as if there wasn't any reality but the camp.
We thought you were dead. The report came in over a year ago. It's like a miracle having you back.
It is a miracle. I keep thinking I'll wake up back there, being driven out to work when the sun came up, thrown back in a hooch when it went down.
Must have been awful. But you're back. You're safe.
Yeah. Nothing can hurt me now. Not here in the States. But I'm afraid if I lean on something, I'll fall through and keep falling till I end up there again.
Look, Dad, you can't let it affect you like that.
Oh, I won't, Sonna. I kept my soul alive thinking about you. My own son. My flesh and blood. I swore I'd come back and make up for all those years we've been apart. If I hadn't had that to hold on to, I'd have gone crazy, Dennis. I'd have jumped one of the guards and made him shoot me.
It's good to have you back. Gonna be part of my life from now on, Dad.
Hey, what are you doing here?
Mrs.
What in the world happened to the gallery?
Mrs. Carrington, I thought you were out in the
Gulf of Mexico with Alex Wheeler.
Well, I was until a few hours ago. Alex heard about Terry being held hostage and had a helicopter take us to the nearest airport, and then we flew right back. What happened here?
Then you haven't heard. Oh, it's just been terrible, Mrs. Carrington. Dawn came here by herself late at night, and somebody attacked her. They beat her up and tried to rape her.
Oh, Paige, no.
And then the animal went around slashing all these beautiful works of art. I mean, it just breaks your heart.
How is she?
Dawn, well, she's all right, physically. But she's having a lot of trouble emotionally. She's recuperating at the ranch right now.
What a terrible thing. Dennis must be very upset.
He is. I guess since the attack, she won't let him near her. Seems she can't stand any kind of closeness. So, this may be a terrible thing to say, but this all may be for the good.
How could it be?
Oh, not the beating. Oh, heavens, but, Dawn's reaction to it. I mean, it's so childish, so immature. I just think Dennis would be better off not marrying someone so unstable. Though I hate to say that about my own baby sister.
I think you're right. Dawn's too young for marriage.
And I just want you to know, Mrs. Carrington, that I'm on your side. As long as I'm here helping Dennis, I'll see to it that he gets an objective point of view.
I appreciate it. Especially since now I may be seeing very little of Dennis.
Really? Why is that?
Well, Alex and I are getting married, and I'm not at all sure how Dennis will react.
Oh, Mrs. Carrington! I think that's wonderful. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Oh, I'm very envious, you know. Oh. Houston's number one bachelor, pursued by many beautiful women for years, and you scoop him up in what, 3 months?
Well, not quite. Alex and I first met 25 years ago.
Oh, you and Alex go that far back?
Yes, we met then and knew each other for a little while, and then we're apart all these long years. I'm wondering, it must be the prospect of being a bride. Well, do you know when Dennis will be back?
Oh, no, I'm not sure. It could be a while. He's with his father.
What? His father? With Alex? I meant with his future stepfather, of course. But Dennis couldn't have heard about our marriage plans, could he? Oh, I don't want him arguing with Alex.
Oh, no, no, no. Of course not. But it seems you're the one who hasn't heard. Dennis is at the airport meeting his father. Eliot Carrington is alive.